You're watching Truth versus Hype. In a court in Mumbai, a trial is underway of 22 men, mostly low-ranked policemen, accused of the fake encounter of Sohrabuddin Sheikh, his wife, and his associate, Tulsi Ram Prajapati. These cops are the last of the accused in this once politically explosive case. In its charge sheet, the CBI had accused BJP President Amit Shah, who was the then Home Minister of Gujarat, as a key part of the conspiracy behind these encounter killings. But barely 7 months after the BJP came to power, in December 2014, Mr. Shah was discharged from the case. And one by one, so were many of the top cops associated with the case, coming out to hero's welcome. Today, 16 of the 38 accused have been discharged from the case. 92 of the 210 witnesses have turned hostile. And just as the case seemed to be slipping from the public radar, a series of explosive testimonies by police officers who are appearing as witnesses in the ongoing trial has turned the focus back on these VIPs who've been let off. Sandeep Tamgarge, the CBI investigating officer who probed the case, told the court that he stood by what his charge sheet said, that there was a criminal political nexus involving Amit Shah and Rajasthan Home Minister Gulab Chand Kataria. He said the CBI found that the principal conspirators to be Amit Shah, Vanzara and other police officers. Amitabh Thakur, another investigating officer of the CBI, said that four of the accused, including Amit Shah, benefited politically and financially from the fake encounter. Now, Amit Shah, as we said, has already been discharged 4 years ago, and the CBI has refused to challenge his discharge. But will these testimonies give a momentum to those who are trying to move the higher courts to get the CBI to challenge the Amit Shah discharge? Because remember, so far all these attempts have been rejected by the higher courts, most recently by the Bombay High Court. All right, joining us on the debate tonight, we have with us from Mumbai, Justice Abhay Thipse. He's a former judge of the Mumbai High Court and someone who recently joined the Congress Party. We also have with us Advocate Ahmed Abdi of the Bombay Lawyers Association, which actually has been pushing for the CBI to challenge the discharge in court. We have with us here Deshratha Nigam, lawyer, political analyst, someone who's a supporter of the RSS, if I may call him that, and Naveen Chomal, a lawyer joining us from Mumbai, also someone who one could say is from the right wing of the political sphere. So can I just start with you, Justice Thipse, because you were somebody who actually heard some of the bail applications of those accused in the Sohrabuddin case. You also granted bail. But you've come out very strongly saying that actually the manner in which this case has unfolded and the manner in which people like Amit Shah have been discharged suggests serious problems with the law. Why do you feel that?
See, when I gave my interview to Indian Express,
yes,
I mentioned why did I feel that.
Yes.
But I will just sum up.
Yes.
Firstly, you know, one must understand that the background of the case itself means it was transferred from Gujarat to the Bombay High Court.
Mm.
And the reason given was that there was a possibility, the CBI's contention was that there was a possibility that one of the accused, and it is named in the Supreme Court order, that Amit Bhai Shah, he will try to influence the witnesses, and that therefore it was not advisable to have it tried in the state of Gujarat.
Mm.
By these observations, the case came to be transferred to the Mumbai High Court, Bombay
yes,
High Court.
Yes, we are aware, Mumbai. Yeah.
Now what has happened? In this case, the accused were denied bail
yes.
for a number of years.
I mean,
by the trial court, even by High Court, their applications were rejected.
Mm.
Now, when the bail applications are rejected, the first consideration before the court is that there exists a prima facie case of serious offences.
Hmm.
Unless there is a prima facie case, bail is given for asking.
Hmm.
So, usually when a bail is denied, it is highly unlikely that the court, same court or subordinate court particularly, will come to a conclusion that there exists no case for proceeding.
Right.
One has to meet a bigger threshold, you know, to seek discharge rather than bail.
Mm.
Because bail is, after all, even if prima facie cases, their bail can be granted.
So what you're
but
saying...
But that is not so with discharge because you are exonerating it totally from the case.
So what you're saying is that...
Yes.
In a situation where a bail is being repeatedly rejected, there is something which obviously the court felt was serious enough. And
not
therefore,
only rejected,
and therefore, how could this court discharge? Now, can I just for the benefit of our viewers, Justice Thipsey, recap for you some of the core points that the CBI made in the charge sheet, which they found was indicting of Amit Shah, which the trial court did not accept. And then you tell me, as a judge, whether that was legitimate. Now, for example, the court said that they did not find convincing one of the claims that the CBI had made, that some Gujarat builders had accused Amit Shah of using Sohrabuddin for extortion. These are the Patel builders of Ahmedabad. The court said, or the judge said, that these are cut and paste statements by these builders. Number two, the CBI charge sheet said there were video conversations which these Patel brothers claimed, which showed pressure brought on these builders by Amit Shah's aides. Again, the judge said this was hearsay. Then there were the testimonies of police officials who said that Amit Shah asked them to destroy evidence in the Sohrabuddin case. G.C. Raigar, who retired as DGP Home Guard, said Shri Amit Shah wasn't happy with my work because I didn't follow his illegal instructions in the case. V.L. Solanki, a police inspector in the CID, said that Mr. Amit Shah asked his superior Geeta Jori to tear off his inquiry reports. Again, the judge said that these are vague, subjective, and are hearsay. Finally, the CBI produced evidence of multiple calls between Amit Shah and the officers involved in the encounter. 38 calls between Amit Shah and Vanzara, 343 calls between Amit Shah and Pandian, Rajkumar Pandian, another officer involved allegedly in the encounter. But the judge said he agreed with Amit Shah's lawyers that this is all part of Amit Shah's hands-on style of functioning of talking to his police officers. They don't in their entirety suggest guilt. Now, do you think that these are legitimate arguments, or as some have argued, that this was too premature at the stage of whether you're deciding, this is not, trial has not started. This is too premature to have dismissed it during the discharge at that stage.
Yes, I will answer your question from the law point.
Hmm.
See, at the stage of discharge, one is not to consider whether the material will stand to ultimate scrutiny.
Right.
It is a settled position, I think you can find in the legal textbooks also, and nobody can dispute that one has to take the statements recorded by the police during investigation at face value.
Right.
Now, face value means you are not to scrutinize that, whether this will stand to scrutiny, because you can't judge the evidence before it is given.
Right.
The witness will come in box and he will state accordingly. That is what is expected.
Right.
Further filing of the charge sheet, it conveys the idea that the investigating agency is satisfied that these offences have been made out by so-and-so persons who are put to trial. Now, the question is, discharge is an extraordinary remedy, which is the parameters are many. But roughly stated, it will be that even if you accept the case as put forth, still there will be absolutely no case for proceeding also. That sort of thing is very rare in session court cases.
Okay, let me ask.
Usually you will not find.
Okay, and, let me come back to you. You're saying this is very rare that this happens and it's unusual.
Yeah.
But let me ask Desh Ratan Nigam, as a lawyer, tell me that you have a very unusual situation here.
Not at all.
Can I ask you the question? You have a situation where on one hand, the CBI is saying, in fact, its officers are coming in this trial and saying as of this week that Amit Shah was the main conspirator, right? On the other hand, the CBI in court, when the Bombay Lawyers Association went to the Bombay High Court and said, please ask the CBI to challenge the discharge, they're saying they've applied their mind to the discharge order and there is no reason to challenge Amit Shah's discharge. So the same agency is speaking in two voices.
Now, presuming what you're saying is right, you remember Judge Loya's case? Somebody else went to the Supreme Court. What stopped all these people to go to the Supreme Court? Finally, Supreme Court settled Judge Loya's case.
We'll ask them whether they're appealing the Supreme Court, but answer the contradiction the same agency
2014
is speaking in two voices.
No, let me answer. I am not going on what agency is saying. I am going what is on record. The record speaks that he was discharged. The evidence, whatever was put, was collected during UPS time, CBI under UPS time, but discharged in the in 2014.
Yes.
So all evidence investigation, presuming that what you're saying is CBI is under influence now, that is what probably you're hinting at.
I'm just asking questions based on hard facts.
No, there are no hard facts here. You know.
No, the hard fact is
the testimony
pre-2014.
Testimony.
CBI says Amit Shah main conspirator, something which the officer who investigated it, two officers, are saying as of this week.
No, fine.
The same agency is telling the Bombay High Court.
Fine.
We have no grounds to challenge this charge.
Amitabh Thakur makes a statement, then he says he has no evidence to support his allegation.
Sandeep Tamgadge?
No, he also doesn't have any evidence.
He says, I'm sorry, I beg to differ. He has told the court, we have evidence to back our claim.
Where is that evidence? Is it on record or they are hiding it?
He is the main conspirator.
Are they hiding it? It should be on record.
It is. It's part of his charge sheet.
No, charge sheet. Then court will see it finally. Court will see while doing it finally. So all those evidence was there at the time of filing the charge sheet. Court saw it and the judge who was on your panel heard only the bail. Bail has nothing to do with discharge. It's only prima facie. And he's mixing the two things. It's not a rare phenomenon. As a lawyer, we have got discharged so many people from the trial course. I think this is politically motivated.
Politically motivated. Okay. Advocate Ahmed Abdi, Bombay Lawyers Association. Now, just the first question to you, because the Bombay High Court has rejected your appeal to challenge the discharge, saying you don't have any locus standi in this case. Are you planning to take this to the Supreme Court?
Yeah, we are planning to file SLP in this matter in the Supreme Court, because we have not went under the criminal law to the Bombay High Court. We gone under Constitution Article 226 seeking mandamus against CBI, because CBI is a premier agency of the country for investigation and prosecution. And this task was assigned by Honorable Supreme Court with great confidence in the CBI that it will behave in impartial way. Some discharges have been challenged by CBI in the High Court and some has been spared. And the same CBI who was opposing Amit Shah's discharge in the trial court,
yes,
they have not challenged his discharge in this High Court. This is a very, very pertinent question. And they have not filed any reply to our PIL also.
Okay.
No reply, only verbal statement, only statement across the bar.
I think PILs are generally not maintainable in criminal cases. You have the appeal, you have all other remedies, but you are going in PIL.
It's a constitutional aspect, not criminal.
Just a second, let me move on. Okay, let me move on to another
case. This is laughable.
Just give me 1 second.
As a lawyer.
Just give me 1 second. Can I just go across, because when it comes to locus, we have on the phone line Rubabuddin Sheikh, who's the brother of Sohrabuddin, because the question is that who has the locus to challenge it? And Rubabuddin, aap hamare saath line pe hain ki ye bataiye ki ye jab vakil gaye high court mein, unhone kaha ki high court CBI ko aadesh de ki aapke brother ke encounter mein jo Amit Shah ka discharge hua usko challenge kariye. Unhone kaha ki Rubabuddin ne ek petition isi silsile mein jari kiya tha, lekin fir unhone wapas le liya. तो अगर फैमिली ही वापस ले रहा है तो फिर हम उसको सीबीआई को क्यों आदेश दे? तो आपने उसको वापस क्यों लिया पिटिशन?
हाँ, वापस किया था.
उसकी क्या वजह थी आप बता सकते हैं?
नहीं बता सकते.
आप पे कोई दबाव?
नहीं आप...
जी रुबाबुद्दीन
जी.
अच्छा, आप एक तरह से इसका ठीक से जवाब नहीं दे पा रहे, लेकिन क्या आप मानेंगे कि सीबीआई इसको ठीक तरह से जांच कर रही है? क्योंकि जिस तरह से हम देख रहे हैं, रुबाबुद्दीन आप खुद देख रहे हैं कि करीब आधे से ज्यादा जो लोग हैं इनका ये सब बरी हो चुके हैं.
सीबीआई इसमें सही से काम नहीं कर रही. सीबीआई जो ट्रायल चल रहा है वो सही नहीं चल रहा है. सीबीआई सही नहीं चल रही. सीबीआई रजनी शाही को नहीं बुलाया, पटेल बंधुओं को नहीं बुलाया एविडेंस के लिए, और तमाम आरोपियों को जाने के उद्देश्य से काम कर रही सीबीआई. कोर्ट उसमें पूरा सपोर्ट कर रही है. जो कोर्ट में चल रहा है वो ठीक नहीं चल रहा है.
ठीक नहीं चल रहा है? अच्छा.
हाँ, जो चल रहा है ठीक चल रहा है. सीबीआई आरोपियों को बचाने के उद्देश्य से काम कर रही है, ये कहा है मैंने. आप मेरी आवाज सुन रहे हैं? आपकी आवाज मुझे साफ नहीं आ रही.
अच्छा, नहीं नहीं, आपकी आवाज हमें साफ आ रही है, लेकिन मैं समझ रहा हूँ आप क्या कह रहे हैं।
मैं फिर से दोहराइए प्लीज, मैंने क्या कहा आपसे? मैंने ये कहा है कि सीबीआई सही तरीके से काम नहीं कर रही और कोर्ट में जो चल रहा है वो ठीक नहीं चल रहा है। सीबीआई ने उसको नहीं बुलाया, पटेल दशरथ परम पटेल को नहीं बुलाया, सीबीआई नजनी चाय को नहीं बुलाया, सीबीआई ने गीताबेन जोहरी को नहीं बुलाया बयान के लिए
जी, तो आप
रिकॉर्ड करने के लिए, और जिस तरीके से कोर्ट में काम चल रहा है वो ठीक नहीं चल रहा है।
अच्छा ठीक है, आप कह रहे हैं ठीक नहीं चल रहा है, बट आप क्यों इसको कोर्ट में आप इसको चैलेंज नहीं कर रहे हैं, ये आप कह रहे हैं आप नहीं हमें बता सकते। तो चलिए रुबाबुद्दीन, आप हमारे शो पे आए, एटलीस्ट थैंक यू फॉर दैट। वन कैन ओनली इमेजिन व्हाट सॉर्ट ऑफ प्रेशर्स यू आर फेसिंग। नवीन चोमल, यू नो, आंसर द पॉइंट दैट एडवोकेट अब्दी वॉज मेकिंग, दैट ऑन वन हैंड यू हैव द सीबीआई सेइंग दैट दे कंसिडर्ड इन दैट चार्ज शीट अमित शाह टू बी द मेन मास्टरमाइंड इन द केस, and now they are telling the court that they have applied their mind and taken a conscious decision not to challenge his discharge. They are challenging the discharge of some police officers based on the same evidence, but not of Amit Shah and other high-ranking police officers like Vanzara. Doesn't this indicate some kind of political pressure, political motivation?
Well, let me try to take the bull by the horn directly.
Hmm.
See, what has been happening and the trend of the previous government, Congress regime, was to somehow witch hunt certain people using CBI as a tool.
Right.
And even in the case of Ishrat Jha, she was made a, what you say, an innocent victim, and they tried to implicate some people. And I think exactly same as occurred in the case of Sohrabuddin. So to come on the TV channel and make some sensational statement is one thing, but to scrutinize the entire matter before the court is altogether different. So the court,
if they pass the order
discharging the persons,
yeah,
I think court has done very sensibly and with all responsibility.
But why is the CBI not challenging
the
discharge?
If the court has not done the responsibility, then I throw the gauntlet to even the...
No, but Mr. Naveen Chomal...
He knows the law, he's a congressman, he knows the way
why
to
not,
Supreme
why,
Court.
Why is the not CBI challenge, not challenging... No, no. Why is the CBI not challenging the discharge?
CBI has given a very clear reason that we agree with what the trial court has opined, that there is no material to proceed against Mr. Amit Shah. So they are very clear. It was the previous government which was pressurizing.
Okay, let me go back
CBI
to Justice
Hipsey. CBI a caged parrot. So
okay, Justice
now the caged parrot is not in the cage.
Okay, Justice Hipsey, this point that the CBI...
So Justice Hipsey can move the Supreme Court. Where is Tista Sehgal?
Okay, just a second, sir. Now I have to move on.
She has been in the Supreme Court
Justice
during the Congress regime.
Wait, I don't want to silence
so
mics, but I will
if
you're not allowing the others to speak. Justice Hipsey, the CBI claiming that we have studied the material,
yes,
and we don't think there's any reason to appeal the discharge. Are you convinced by that?
How can he be convinced? He's a congressman.
No, I am not convinced by that, because I have never seen the investigating agencies actually deciding it from a judicial point of view. If according to them the case is correct and their allegations are true, then they go up to the highest level. That is what we usually see. It is not that they just read the judgment and they understand the law and they feel that this judgment is legally sound and we don't decide that. Even if an agency takes a decision not to appeal, that is taken at a higher level, not at the level where who investigate. Secondly, I will make a point. Somebody, the other panelist said, one of them, I don't remember who said, that bail and discharge are totally different. He tried to say that it is quite possible that bail is not obtained, but later on discharge is given. In that respect, I would say that it is never based on the same material. Secondly, when bail is not granted on the ground, not because investigation is pending or anything, but because there exists a strong prima facie case. Now, on the same material, you can't say that this is not sufficient even for proceeding. Forget about conviction.
Okay,
even
this is getting a bit technical.
It is not sufficient.
He's biased.
I can challenge that there will be no such case.
Okay, that's getting a bit technical. Justice, this is getting a bit technical for our viewers. This is getting a bit technical because all of you are very, you know, you're all legal minds. So this can get a bit technical.
So
One second, Mr. Chomal. Let me just go across. Let me go back to Advocate Abdi, because Advocate Abdi, if the courts are not accepting the locus standi of parties like yourself, we just heard Rubabuddin there saying he withdrew the case and he cannot tell us why, then where is this going to go?
That is why this group of lawyers went, because too many individuals went under criminal law.
Yeah.
Intervention applications were made, criminal applications were made, all were dismissed on the ground
but
of
even,
locus.
And,
and some were withdrawn. Now you have seen the statement of Sohrabuddin. What
yeah.
he is saying?
Yeah.
The court is not, the things are not working properly. It is
yes.
not going in the right direction. And why he has withdrawn, you can understand. The conclusion can be drawn.
Right.
That's why
so
this body of lawyers challenge it.
Legal.
Because the individuals,
let's come back to legal
individuals
principles.
May not be able to withstand the pressure.
Hmm.
Let us
see,
come back to Mr. Abhi on legal principles.
Whose opinion can be so binding over the
on
court.
Legal principles.
Ultimately, the judge, you can
on legal principles,
the
Deshratan Nigam explained this. The CBI, on the same evidence, challenges the discharge of N.K. Amin and two Rajasthan sub-inspectors, but not of the others, on exactly the same evidence.
See,
explain
the,
that.
No, evidence is always seen with respect to persons A, B, C. You know, vis-a-vis those person, how much that evidence would hold against A, B or C, individually, not collectively. So, in its own wisdom, and CBI does not work in vacuum. They have enough legal advice from lawyers when they
yes.
look at the attorneys that they have. And after
how
looking
can it be
at,
both a caged parrot and be taking all this legal advice? It
no,
can't
no,
be both at the same
no,
time.
No. See, caged parrot, all is all in political domain. And Supreme Court, when said at that point of time, was really bad. There were real political interferences going on. So
you're saying that at that time there was political interference.
Yes.
Now there is no interference.
Supreme Court.
Today,
Supreme Court said
the
so.
The highest ranking officers of the CBI are openly at war with each other.
Yes.
Claiming political interference, attributing
has
political
Supreme,
intervention.
Has Supreme
so
Court
you're saying,
let
now
me,
you're
let
saying
me answer. Let
dairy.
Me let me answer. The matter is sub judice before Supreme Court. These are allegations that have come. In the earlier case, Supreme Court made observations of this kind.
Right.
Today, till now, Supreme Court has not made any kind of observation. No, those two must be should have been sacked long time back, you know, for misconduct.
Okay.
That
but
they have
over
done.
Time. But it's very interestingly poised, this case. And I think that what Sohrabuddin said today, or rather he didn't say itself, is very significant. But thank you all so much for joining us on the show tonight. That's it on Truth vs. Hype. Thanks for watching. Good night.